12th of June, 2016, my debut on Top Gear, and I had the responsibility of reviewing arguably one of the most important cars of that year, and maybe one of the most significant cars of the last few years, the Ford Focus RS. I remember it well because I was there in a studio with about 800 other people, big audience, stood opposite Joey from Friends, and he was laying into me because I'd said on my little VT of that car that you can keep your Ferraris, keep your Porsches, keep your Paganis, I'm keeping the Ford Focus RS because that car in the real world is, and I think these were my words, the best fast car you can buy right now. And I said that because on real roads, in the real world, a greasy B road in Wales somewhere, there's probably not a lot of cars I think that would keep up with a Focus RS. And more to the point, I don't think there's many cars that would give you as much enjoyment and confidence. And Matt, fair play to him, he actually understood exactly what I was talking about, and he went out and he bought his own Focus RS on my recommendation, and he loves it. It was a big statement, but it's one that I stand by even to this day, because I still think that the Focus RS is arguably the best hot hatch of the last 10 years, maybe more. But even though the car was amazing, Ford have decided to kill it off completely. It's 2020 now, and they've ceased production of the Focus RS entirely, and they have no plans to develop a new version of the RS based on the current Ford Focus. That begs the question, why? Well, it all comes down to two things, money and CO2. Ford's official stance for the cancellation is that as a result of pan-European emission standards, increased CO2 taxation, and the high cost of developing an RS with some form of electrification for a relatively low volume of vehicles, they're not planning another RS version of the Focus. In other words, here's the deal. There are some really strict new carbon dioxide emission standards being rolled out for car manufacturers in the EU. Under the new rules, car makers have to cut their average fleet emissions across their entire range to 95 grams of CO2 per kilometer by 2021. And each car maker has its own targets based on the types of cars they make and the number they sell, so Ferrari won't have the same target as Kia, but the idea across the industry is for the average to be 95 grams per kilometer or less. I don't know what Ford's target is specifically, but let's just say that across the board, their cars currently emit 95 grams of CO2 per kilometer. Then you've got the Focus RS, which emits 175 grams per kilometer. So that massively, that one car raises the average quite significantly. If they get rid of the Focus, bang, their average falls back down to 95. And there's a big incentive to reach that target, because if they don't, then they're gonna get fined €95 per gram of CO2 above the 95 grams per kilometer figure, multiplied by the number of cars they sell in the EU. Ford sell around 1 million cars in the EU every single year. €95 times 1 million. It's a big fine, so they had to get rid of the Focus RS. It had to be one of the big CO2 emitters, either the Mustang or the Focus RS, but the Mustang sells in big numbers. It's the biggest selling sports car in the world right now. And they're not gonna touch that, believe me, there'd be riots in Texas. So they had to make big cuts elsewhere, and they did make massive cuts. In 2018, Ford announced that they'd no longer be making any more passenger cars in the US. So no more hatchbacks, no more sedans, they'd only be concentrating on making SUVs and pickup trucks. So that begs the question, why can't Ford just make a cleaner engine and throw it in the Focus RS and let that car live on outside of America? Well, they've been looking into that. They've actually worked on developing hybrid engines, both mild hybrids and full hybrids. In fact, they already have them. They have a mild hybrid system in the new Ford Puma and an existing version of the Ford Mondeo with a full hybrid system. The Mondeo hybrid uses a 2-liter engine with a motor and a battery pack, but it's completely unsuitable because it only makes 187 horsepower and the emissions are still 131 grams per kilometer. That's not good enough to be an ST, let alone a Focus RS. And that's before we even start thinking about the extra weight it would add and the fact that it's still nowhere near green enough for what Ford need in order to sneak their cars below that 95 grams per kilometer limit. As for the mild hybrid solution, well, the Ford Puma's a great little car, but again, the engine is unsuitable. It's a 1-liter engine, which only makes 155 metric horsepower, and the CO2 only just scrapes that 95 gram per kilometer limit. So the most logical step is to develop a brand new engine that meets all of their requirements. But the amount of money this would take is absolutely outrageous. They may well do it eventually, But for the time being, it seems like the RS brand, in terms of the Focus at least, is dead in the water. Unless they start thinking completely outside the box. As far as I see it, they still have three good options. One of which is to partner with somebody else to develop a new engine that delivers big power and low emissions, split the bill, and give us a new RS plus a new sports car from whichever partner that ends up using this co-developed engine. The sort of thing that might make sense, and I'm not sure this is even possible from a packaging perspective, is the engine that they use in the Volvo XC90. So it's the T8 plug-in hybrid system, which makes 400 horsepower and 49 grams per kilometer of CO2. Imagine a 400 horsepower Focus RS. Okay, yeah, the Volvo engine probably wouldn't fit, it might be too heavy, but it would be so much fun. The next solution will be to continue the RS legacy by developing a Fiesta RS. Right now, the Fiesta ST makes 200 horsepower, but could it be cranked up to 250? Could it be given the all-wheel drive from the last Focus RS? Imagine a Fiesta RS with big power, launch control, drift mode. It would be completely awesome. Or the third option, and this is going completely left field, is to use the existing powertrain from one of their cars, which makes about 337 horsepower and zero emissions. That's right, I'm talking about the internals from the all-electric Mustang Mach-E. Could it work in a Focus RS? I mean, it would certainly be a massive departure, but until recently, nobody thought it would even be possible that Ford would put an electric motor in a car with a Mustang badge. It's definitely something worth thinking about, especially since these new emissions targets aren't going anywhere anytime soon. Quite the opposite, in fact. Sure, right now, they're aiming to have all manufacturers conform to the average of 95 grams of CO2 per kilometer by 2021, but beyond that, they're actually aiming to push that limit down even lower to 66 grams per kilometer. Now that means that it's not just your favorite performance cars like the Focus RS that are in danger of becoming extinct. Some of your favorite everyday cars that we might actually consider to be quite green currently are in danger of going the way of the dodo. Do you wanna know which cars? Well, let me know in the comments below and I might do a follow-up episode of this in the near future if this is the kind of content that you guys wanna see. In the meantime, it's not all doom and gloom. At least right now, we still have the option to buy cars like the Focus RS on the secondhand market. And right now on autotrader.co.uk, there are some cracking deals to be had with the Focus RS. And because they're not gonna make another version of this car anytime soon, these things might actually end up being a pretty good investment. But as always, I know it's bad news, it sounds horrible, but go and check out some of our other content. And as always, thank you so much for watching. See you again soon.